In this video, I'm looking at PAG 9, Rate of Reaction, Continuous Monitoring. So the skills covered in the PAG include the measurement of rate by a continuous monitoring method, the measurement of time, and the use of appropriate software to process data. Now, I've put that third one in a bracket because it's very unlikely that they would ask about that in a chemistry exam, so I'm not going to cover that in the video. So the task I'm going to use is this one, so if I have a quick read through and then you can pause the video, have a go and then play on when you're ready for the answers. So a student's been asked to investigate the effect of change in the concentration of acid on the rate of reaction between magnesium and hydrochloric acid, and he's been provided with 2 mole per decimeter cubed HCl and some magnesium ribbon. So you can see there's the reaction equation. So we've got to outline a method using continuous monitoring that the student could use to show that the reaction is first order with respect to the HCl. And in our answer, we have to show how the results could be used to confirm the order. So we'll start with the method. You can see I've written there in brackets gas collection. So that's the method I'm using, and that's because the product, or one of the products, is a gas. So I'm saying to measure out an excess quantity of the 2 mole per decimeter cubed hydrochloric acid. So for example, you could use 50 cm cubed of acid, measure that out using a measuring cylinder, and transfer it to a conical flask or boiling tube. And you can see there in brackets, that would equate to 0.1 moles of acid. I'll come back to that in a moment. Next thing to do would be to measure out a mass of magnesium ribbon. So for example, I'm using 0.1 grams, and that's obviously measured out using a 2 decimal place balance. Okay, so 0.1 grams of magnesium is 0.004 moles of magnesium. So you can see the ratio in the equation is 1 to 2. So we would need 0.008 moles of acid to exactly react with that. But you can see I'm using a lot more than that. I'm using 0.1, so it's in excess. We then add the magnesium ribbon to the acid and quickly fit a delivery tube connected to a gas syringe. I'll show you a diagram of what that looks like in a moment. We need to record the volume of hydrogen gas produced at regular intervals, so for example every 20 seconds, until the reaction stops, i.e. all the magnesium reacts. Remember, the acid's in excess. So the next thing I'm saying to do is we need to dilute that 2 mole per decimeter cubed hydrochloric acid down to 1 mole per decimeter cubed. In other words, we're halving the concentration. So how would we do that? We'd measure out 25 cm cubed of the acid, the original acid, and add it to 25 cm cubed of water. So we then repeat the experiment that we did before, using this new 1 mole per decimeter cubed HCl. And you can see, remember, we're using the same amount of magnesium, so in terms of acid we'd need 0.008 moles of acid, remember. We've still got excess acid. So then I'm saying to make another concentration of acid, so we're diluting it now to 0.5 moles per decimeter cubed. How would you do that? 12.5 cm cubed of acid into 37.5 cm cubed of water. So that total volume is always 50 cm cubed. And again, you can see that the acid's still in excess. We've got more than 0.008 moles of acid. And then, of course, we'd repeat the experiment using this new concentration of acid. So what's the apparatus going to look like? Well, you can either use the conical flask connected to the gas syringe or boiling tube connected to the gas syringe. You could even use this method where you collect the gas over water. Personally, I'd go for one of these two because the gas syringes are far more accurate than that upside down measuring cylinder. So if we look at how to analyse the results now, so the first thing you would do is plot graphs on the same axes of the volume of hydrogen against time. So they would be for those 3 different concentrations of acid. You'd then, for each one, calculate the initial rate of the reaction by drawing tangents to the curves at time 0. Now I've got a set of graphs to show you in a moment, so I'll point out how to do that in a second. You'd then compare the three gradients of those tangents, and then if the reaction is first order with respect to the HCl, your results should show that when the concentration of the HCl is halved, the rate halves as well. So here are those graphs I was talking about. So these are based on actual results that I've done. And you can see that we've got three curves on the same set of axes, volume of hydrogen on the y-axis, time running along the bottom on the x-axis. So this curve here is for the most concentrated acid, the 2 moles per decimeter cubed. This one here is for the 1 mole per decimeter cubed. And this one here is for the 0.5 moles per decimeter cubed. So all I've done is constructed tangents to the curves at T0. So I've got the red one, the blue one, and the green one. And I've calculated the gradients for those three tangents, and that's given me a measure of the initial rate for each reaction. So you can see for the red one, the change in Y is 80, and the change in X is around about 23. And so that gives me a gradient of 3.5 cubic centimetres of hydrogen per second. The blue one, 1.6 centimetres cubed per second, and the green one, 0.74 cm cubed per second. So hopefully you can see from the numbers that the blue rate is approximately, it's not exactly, but approximately half the red rate, and so therefore that halving in concentration of the acid has brought about an approximate halving of the rate. And the same you can see between the blue and the green. So we're going from 1.6 to 0.74. Now, these are actual experimental results, so you're never going to see an exact halving of the rate. But it definitely does show the pattern that we were expecting.